And of course, he just destroys everything. Yeah, you can tell he's higher level. So this is a trial build. Does that mean more of those low level virus thingies? I'm fine with those, just keep them coming.
Bye.
No, really, it would be troublesome if they threw high level enemies at us, no? So they're that way.
Mm-hmm.
Please don't jinx it. Wait, that thing is level 60? It's a jinx state. Better stay on your guard, yeah. I'll try to knock it down as fast as possible. Yeah, he's level 60, alright. 20,000 HP. Yeah, I'm just gonna dodge. Quite a bit of experience for a single monster. At least we got that out of the way. Let's go on. Yep, can't see anything. Somebody mind turning on the light? Thank you. Oh, it's just a room? Looks like a lobby of sorts. It's strangely familiar, but I can't quite pinpoint it. This is weird. It's very weird.
Why?
I don't know. Something just feels very weird. It's probably about time for me to log out. Huh. Looks like we'd spent enough time in the room. So what exactly was the point of all this? I really don't get this place. Let's go. Oh, Yeah, I can probably just... Yeah, that actually works. Good. I might come back here later and get the items. So I suppose we should hand in the quest at the hologram portal again? Thank you for fulfilling your objective. Please return to your room and rest for today. Expect your next mission soon. What? That's got to be the laziest quest writing I've ever seen. And did I get this right? We're supposed to return to our rooms? Do they seriously assign rooms to all the players here? What is this, some kind of prison? This is stupid, you know what? I'll just look up, right now. Got a look up how to get out of this place. Anyway, thanks for playing with Milia. See you soon. Bye. This is kind of low. What? Am I still in the game? This can't be right. Again? Is the system broken? I just removed the... Oh. I can't remove the cross gear. What is going on here? Am I stuck in the game now, or what? Wait... Hey YouTube, what is it with this place? Not the sesame season with pepper and oregano. So good. Hey, are you listening to me? The lemon juice and the pineapple still fried for 20 minutes. What the heck is wrong with you? What's up, man? Dude, what is it with this place? Sorry, I don't know. Can't you look out either? Nope, none of us can. What? We are stuck here. You must be joking. Hey, Metal Face, talk to me! Wait... Damn it, this can't be real. No, don't attack them! Damn it all! Okay then. I just died and respawned, didn't I? Well, at least we won't die in real life when we die in game, that's something. You remember that strange feeling I mentioned before? I figured it out, I can't remember things. I can't remember what is outside of the game. Is it the same for you? I see. Things are just very blurry right now. Do you think our memories were rotten? It did already happen for you. That is good to know. There's got to be a way out of this. There just has to be. Let's return to our rooms, okay? Maybe there is a way to properly rest in there, however that works. Yeah, do I understand this correctly? All the avatars in this area can all log out. Why? Sorry, I do not know. This is all extremely bizarre. I looked a bit into this place. Yeah, is something the matter? Please go ahead, I will tell you later. Okay, so I guess we're supposed to find our rooms? And our rooms this way. Doesn't seem like it. Start, layout. I guess we could try figuring out how to get there. Shouldn't be too difficult. I mean, especially now that we have an actual way. Also that. That's one less item to get. And one I can line from here. Okay, so there's 12 more than one more that I haven't actually found. What have I? It's probably on the top barrier or something. Doesn't really lead anywhere, does it? No, but there's the way up, I guess. Can we only go around this way? Yeah. And there. The room isn't even dangerous at yours too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but before we do any of that. Chest! That's equipment. That's quite a bit of a bonus. I lose health regen. I think I'm gonna keep health regen, thank you very much. So I can take that out for now, and I'll keep exploring the area later. Corridor. Mm-hmm. Well, here we are. My room's up here. Yours? I see. Let's try to rest and meet up tomorrow. We'll see what happens. Mm-hmm. Bye. Good night, Leah. Looks like we're locked in again. Mm-hmm. This whole situation is creating stranger every minute. Okay, first, about this place, Vermilion Wasteland was the name, right? This place was originally developed for Crossworlds, but the project was put on hold. They already developed a large part of the environment, but ultimately, the area was never integrated into the playground. No avatar is supposed to enter this place. How? I've been wondering that too. How could these avatars end up in this place? Mm-hmm. How? Huh? You mean something else? No, do you wonder how I know all of this? Mm-hmm. Well, I suppose there is no point in hiding it. I am an entertainment employee. I have been involved in the creation of Crossworlds for many years already. That is why I have access to internal documents, some of them at least. Still, I was not aware that development of this region had continued in any way. This place should be abandoned for all I know. I mean, it is possible this is a confidential project we are not supposed to know about, but I highly doubt that. The fact that the avatars here cannot seem to look out is even more strange. Mm-hmm. And the loss of memory as well. Yes, just like Julia, their situation is very similar to yours. But I doubt these players are all in a coma. Why? Yeah, there's something I... No. Sorry, I think I just misunderstood something. Why? Anyway, there is nothing we can do in this room. So just suggest we call it a day, alright? Wait, why? Yeah, please, there is nothing left to talk about. Bye. Good night. Now, like, she can actually look out? So, how did it go so far? First results are pretty positive. He recognized her immediately. Otherwise, he recalls things more quickly, I think. Good. Please keep a close eye on them. Oh, you're awake. You looked so peaceful while you were sleeping. I didn't want to wake you up. Anyway, shall we revisit the lesson from yesterday? Hello. Long time no see. They denied my proposal. Again. Damn it. Damn it! I'm here to come up with interesting game scenarios and challenges. I need a little bit of creative freedom to do my job. Gautam, that is what teamwork is all about. You have to find a compromise. Tch, the best we'll ever get is mediocre that way. There are too many conventional thinkers in this company. Right, Satoshi? What can I say? They just want to keep making the games they know. They have a genius like you on board and don't make proper use of it. Rejecting your big AI project proposal. Well, to be honest, that went way beyond what you would need for a game like Crossworlds. Are you sure? I think there are a lot of applications. In fact, I'm currently working on a list of them. So you plan to pitch the idea to them again? Of course I will. It's just way too promising. What? I don't work that much, really. And I do it because it's what I want to do. No need to worry. You should listen to your dear caring sister, Mr. Workaholic. You too, Sergi! Wait! Oh, good morning, Leah. Did you have another dream? Good. Do you remember something new? Was it another place? Or was it a person? Oh, it's new. Okay, who could it be? Was it an avatar? Somebody locked into Crossworlds? Okay, not a player then. Was it Gautam by any chance? Of course, you saw him yesterday. This must have triggered the memory. Do you see anybody else? You saw me? Was there a third person? Like messy hair, green figure. That must have been Satoshi. Okay, Mia. I think now is the right time to tell you more about yourself. Yes, I do know a few things about you. We have known each other in the past. However, I thought it was safest for you to recover your memories by yourself. After all, this is part of your healing process. Anyway, if you remember Gautam, Satoshi and me, this must have been from about 5 years ago. Back then, all of us were employees of Instatainment. That is right, we were all involved in the development of Crossworlds. And Satoshi, he is your brother. I am sure you will remember more about him soon. Anyway, about 4 years ago, all three of you went missing. Nobody knew exactly what happened to you. There was no way to track you down. Believe me, I tried. That was until I found you again, lying in the hospital. And with you being awake in Crossworlds, your memories are my only lead to Satoshi and the others. I want to get you to wake up, and I want to find out what exactly has happened to you and the others. Whatever did happen, I am sure it has to do with this place. I get the feeling we're very close to the answers. Oh yes, it looks like the door was unlocked some time ago. In fact, I am a bit late with your login. Something was holding me up again. Lucas is probably waiting for you outside. Ah, there you are.
Hi.
I've been waiting for you. Looks like you had your first share of beauty sleep. Yeah! Well, I mean, it does feel like sleeping once you log out, right? I'm just glad they allow you to do that once you enter your room. I really needed the break after what happened yesterday. I sure lost my nerves, didn't I? Not very proud of that. I'm really impressed how well you're taking all of this. Anyway, let's go to the hub again. They won't let me take today's quest unless I form a party with you. Well then. Alright, ready to get to this quest. Recruits, welcome back to Project Red. Today we don't have any particular task for you. Feel free to explore the area and go back to your room if you want to rest. That is all. Good luck and be careful. Wait, that's all? They just want us to walk around and that's it? Oh, Jens. Seriously, this campaign is the worst. Actually, I had a look around before and I found a few nice places. So, since there's nothing to do you want me to show you around? Alright then, follow me! Well then, welcome to my little Vermilion Wasteland tour. I will show you all the remarkable sights of this truly underappreciated landscape. Please come this way.
Is it really?
Forbidden area, huh? Here we are in the town center. The town doesn't really have a name, so let's just stick with Vermilion Town for now. Vermilion Town, home of the metal blocks and endless pipes. Nobody actually knows what's in the pipes though. We are probably best off not knowing. Vermilion Town is also home of these friendly metal armored fellows. Like most folks, they don't like to be hit. They really don't like it. What am I saying? You saw what happened yesterday. Also, be especially careful about that area in turn. They really don't like you to return. Well, what am I saying? You already went ahead and explored the whole area, right? Now, let's exit the town to the west. So, we are just out of town and... Oh, look! It's one of these devices. Yet the Almighty Plot decided we're not ready to proceed, so these things remain unresponsive. Nothing to do here, so let's appreciate the amazing nature of this place. This way! This is kinda funny. This is a lake.
Why?
Because it's filled with water or whatever that purple stuff is.
Why?
Sorry, this tour doesn't include basic scientific explanations.
Bye!
Yeah, what a tough customer. I'm sure Tronny would have a good explanation for you. And he'd probably also complain about those weird rock formations. Let's continue, off to the north. Be careful not to step on the virus along the way. On a virus along the way. We haven't actually gone to the north. Now we enter the realm of Ebony Forest. As expected, it's full of stress. Yet there are no evil wolves in this forest. It's just fair viruses as always. Also no dogs. I'm sure Emily would be glad to hear that. Seriously though, Emily and her fear of dogs. I don't quite get it. She made such a huge deal out of the Fajr Temple boost. That giant moth, right? But when I asked her about the meat boost, the landline, no problem to her.
How?
Yeah, apparently it's all good because it's slow and stuck in the sand. Personally, I thought the landline was much higher on the scary scale. Actually, I don't worry about that. Right, well, that's Emily for you. Let's continue. Over there is a pretty interesting spot. I call this here the Field of Indecisive Flowers. This is because they can't decide to what height to grow. I mean, just look at them. Some are stuck on ground level, others several meters high.
Why?
Look, I can't even explain a lake to you, so what do you expect now? Anyway. Those flowers are awfully convenient for an elaborate jumping pad, don't you think? I mean, this wouldn't be crosswords without unlikely jumping pads literally everywhere. The only thing I'm missing here is the treasure chest to collect. I suppose we both can guess when the flowers will come into play. Enough of this forest, let's go back to the lake. There is one more location I want to show you.
Hmm.
Maybe, but first. Jumping puzzle. It really didn't lead anywhere. I don't think I could go to the side with that. Maybe. There's more plants and stuff. I'm really just looking around for a treasure chest or something like that. Understandably so, some people have been losing their minds. And that one's timed. Because of course it is. This way. Which then does that. But that still doesn't really unlock anything, does it? I wonder. That actually did anything, but hey, we can hope, I guess. Actually, hope is really the right word. Oh, almost fell off. Yeah, it's like you can get to all of those connected places, but they don't really lead anywhere. Oh well, I'm sure we will find out eventually. Alright, our final site will be further to the west. And this is the cliffside.